Hey everyone, this is Raja, Enterprise Agile Coach from ProXL Consulting. However, there are a lot of issues people face in following this traditional model. So before I speak about those issues or challenges of traditional lifecycle model, I would request you to list down from your own perspective, from your own experience, what are all the major challenges or issues you are currently facing with this traditional lifecycle model? Either waterfall or V, any of those sequential model that you follow, what are the issues you are facing? I would suggest pause this video, take about 10 minutes, come up with all the list. If required, you can also involve your team members so that you will get to know the complete set of issues. Once you are ready with the list of issues, we will continue further. Please pause the video. Okay, hope you have come up with a decent list of issues. Let's look at those issues. Unfortunately, I cannot see the list of issues you currently have, but let me go through the list that I have faced myself personally. Plus, I have conducted this training almost all over the world. I have interacted with so many different developers and I have listened to them in my live training, various issues that they are facing. So let's try to go over the list one by one. So the first one, the most popular issue of traditional software development is unclear requirements or ambiguous requirements. Almost everybody complained about this. And the second one, requirements change. Customers change their mind halfway through the development lifecycle. We are already in the coding phase, customer comes up with completely new requirement. So requirements change during the development lifecycle after the requirements phase. And lack of involvement of the customer. Traditionally, in this life cycle, customers are involved in the initial requirements phase and they may or may not be involved during design and coding phase, and finally they come back and get involved in the final testing phase, usually the user acceptance testing phase. So in between, there is a big gap between development community and the customers. And customers keep waiting to see the product for a long time. So lack of involvement of customers. Then accuracy of estimation, probably because of the unclear requirements. When you start with unclear requirements, then your estimation cannot be very accurate, unfortunately. So estimation is an issue. Then uneven loading of resources. Say for example, during requirements phase, we involve business analysts. During design phase, we need architects. During coding phase, we need programmers or developers. During testing phase, we need testers. So these people are not leveled throughout the development lifecycle. They come and perform a role in different phases of the lifecycle. So the resources are not leveled properly. And then last minute correction is very difficult, primarily because of this sequential way of developing software. If at all customer wants some change in the last minute, it's really very difficult to make that change. So that was another problem mentioned by other developers. And not much time is available for testing. Unfortunately, the design may get delayed, the coding may get delayed, but you have to still maintain the end delivery date. So unfortunately, you may not get much time for testing. And because you don't have much time for testing, you may not have much time for fixing defects. Obvious. Another issue faced by people are a lot of documentation. You need requirement specification document, you need design document, you need various program documents, you need test plans, test cases, and you need configuration management document. So many different documents need to be prepared for this traditional life cycle. And most of the people complain there is a schedule and cost overrun. Probably because of ambiguous requirements, probably because of requirements change, probably because of our own lack of planning or improper planning. But schedule and cost overrun do happen. And interesting one, lot of midnight oils just before the final delivery. I have never seen a development team working peacefully just before the final delivery and then peacefully deliver that to the client. Almost every probably 2-3 weeks before the final delivery, everyone slogs, works up to 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock midnight, almost every day. So a lot of midnight oils before final delivery. And finally, customers are not happy with what they see. End of all those hurdles, finally customers are not happy. So these are the issues with traditional software development. Probably you may have something more in your list. But I think reasonably we have captured the decent list of issues.